I regard traditional Hawaiian music as the foundation for myself. And so if you look at so much of the history of Hawaiian music, it's incredible to see how much the music has changed. I think that's the beauty of the diverseness of the music in Hawaii. What songs inspire me and what songs capture my heart and my thoughts, that's what I'm gonna play. I can appreciate doing a really neat spin on a super traditional song. I'm very open to allowing that creativity, certainly. I'm guilty of it.
Ka alai i ka u.
During high school, we participated in that famous island talent contest called Brownbacks to Stardom. I'm a graduate of Kalani High School, but I represented Kaiser High School. The majority of the guys that I played with attended Kaiser High School. That kickstarted our career, I guess you could say, and immediately we started playing in Waikiki and just kind of honing and practicing my musicianship. From there, decided to go into a solo career. I'm having fun at it, and I'm just looking forward to creating more music. Ke aloha no waipiʻo. This is a song written by Kainani and speaking about a group of her friends taking a little day trip down to Waipiʻo. Anytime you're given someone's creation that they've put so much thought and energy into, it's a huge honor. I want to try and represent it as well as I can. It's a collaboration, so it has to fall in line with what the composer is thinking and feeling, and also has to sort of fall in line with how I interpret music. And when those two can kind of meet up, then, you know, something often great can happen. You know, I'm lucky I get to make music with good friends. On the guitar, Jack Ofoia, I would consider him the buffer in many instances. He's the guy who sometimes, if there's something going on, he's like, hey, you know, maybe think about it this way, da-da-da, you know. And on bass is Alika Boy Kalauli, the fourth. Describe him as a giant teddy bear. It really is a relationship. It's almost like a marriage. Japan has been a great place for us to go and work. They embrace not only music and dance, but almost just about every aspect of the culture. We continue to go there at least once a month. We've been doing so for close to 15 years now. We have Yuko Hashimoto visiting from Niigata. We threw Koalian in the mix because I like the choreography that went on in Yuko's hula. We were able to breathe new life into it. And, you know, like I said, we often visit old songs. Kulani, it's always been a favorite place of mine to stay. For years and years, my family and I, you know, patroned the hotel, and my kids and I were in the pool swimming. One of the security guards came over to reconfirm if we were actual guests of the hotel. And then when I asked why, they said, you know, it's that person there. She doesn't think you're a guest, and she wants to have you and your kids removed from the pool. And so I showed them our key, and it would have been easy for me to just, you know, fly off the handle. But And so, and then it got me thinking, I want to do the same too. Can you confirm for me if this lady is a guest? They didn't want to do that because this is what they told me. They didn't want to offend the lady. It just bothered me. It wasn't until later that I found myself actually a little angry about it. And that's what prompted me to write the letter. It wasn't a nasty letter. It was just pretty much matter of fact. Not like I was looking to make this huge impact, but in this day and age, when something goes viral on social media, yeah, it can catch the attention real fast of people. You know, hopefully it brought a little bit more of an awareness. Racism can rear its head often, and I like to think Hawaii is a little different in regards to being more accepting. I have to also be careful and remember I don't want to do that to someone else, you know? So it's a good lesson for everybody. I get to play with Jack and Alika. I know they feel my energy and vice versa. And when we feed off of each other, I'll sing with a little more gusto, or it's just easier for me to reach a note, and all these things culminate and come to that head. I think that's where a lot of musical magic can happen, and then we just enjoy the moment in the song, you know? Aloha, no. I feel blessed in the fact that I get to do what I love to do. It's always been something I've enjoyed since a young boy, and so to be able to carry it over into sustaining me and my family and my life all this time, I've been lucky.
Aloha. This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.